Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this very special event. It's a photo exhibition and eulogy in celebration of the last leader of the African liberation era and the founding president of the Republic of Zambia, Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. You're welcome. My name is Kafui Day. It's a pleasure to be your master of ceremonies for this event, which will be filled with tributes, eulogies, poetry, and performances in honor of a truly great African liberation hero, Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. I'd like to bring onto the stage to formally welcome you, our host for today's event. And we are pleased to have the chair and leader of the Convention People's Party, the party that led us into independence so many years ago, 6th of March, 1957. She's in the person of Nana Frimpomah Sapong Kuma Kuma, our host.
Thank you very much. Distinguished guests, government officials, dignitaries of foreign missions in Ghana, Pan-Africans, and friends, thank you for your presence. I am indeed honored to have you all gathered here. Osagyefo Dr. Kwame Nkrumah once said, "The independence of Ghana is meaningless unless it is linked up with the total liberation of the African people." It is this inspiration in this thought that connects we, the people of Ghana, to the Zambians. The bond between our two leaders, Osagyefo Dr. Kwame Nkrumah and Dr. Kenneth Kaunda, connects their respective parties, the CPP and the UNIP. Dr. Kaunda, one of the last of a generation of African liberation leaders, whom we are all bidding farewell, deserves this fitting tribute. I am moved by his passing, by the passing of Dr. Kaunda, who has been hailed as a torchbearer for freedom all over Africa. The passing of Africa's beloved freedom fighter, Dr. Kaunda, is indeed the end of an era whose significance for you and I, our children and generations unborn, cannot be overemphasized. An era that seeded the strengthening of bonds of solidarity amongst all Africans at home and in the diaspora that we of the CPP hold in very high esteem. It seems to me that with the departure of the last of the freedom fighters, our work achieving the total liberation of Africa is well and truly cut for us. We must ensure a new awakening in ourselves and the younger generation with the goal of leading them to achieve intellectual maturity by thinking for themselves to improve their lot. When we look within for strength, we will indeed realize that the attainment of true liberation rests on our self-reliance. We of the CPP bear the touch of Pan-Africanism and hold it in trust for the youth to draw confidence and to stand, to fight, and to pursue development in liberation. This is one way to honor Dr. Kaunda, his patriots, and all of Africa. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Abibi Groma, for giving us, treating us to some beautiful Kete music and dance. It's royal music and dance. Thank you. We appreciate you. So I was going through a couple of Kaunda quotes, for want of a better designation, and I came across quite a few interesting ones. I'll be sharing some of them as the program continues. And I like this one. Let the West have its technology and Asia its mysticism. Africa's gift to world culture must be in the realm of human relationships. Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. I love that one. Yes. And thanks to our host, Nana Frimpomah, Sapong Kumankuma, chair of the CPP, for your opening remarks. And now we have a couple of remarks from three different people representing, I believe in all, in their ways, diverse ways, Pan-Africanism, because that's what Dr. Kaunda stood for. And I'm going to start with a representative from the Marcus Mosiah Garvey Foundation to give us thoughts and reflections. Naomi Palmer Buchanan, with a round of applause, please.
How are you? Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for the invitation to come here today to represent the life, celebrate the life of Kenneth Kaunda, as we know him as a prolific freedom fighter. Okay. Today, the Marcus Messiah Garvey Foundation would like to pay tribute to Dr. Kenneth David Kaunda, one of Africa's great leaders who fought for African independence and liberation. The passing of Dr. Kenneth Kaunda marks the end of a generation of leaders who inspired the independence struggle in Africa. He was a key figure in transforming the former Northern Rhodesia into modern-day Zambia. President Kaunda was a pioneering leader, a Zambian nationalist, and a Pan-African visionary. In his robust determination to obtain maximum value for Zambia's main export copper, President Kaunda was forced to confront the stranglehold of a capitalist market which stifled Zambia's trust for adequate returns for their mineral resources. Landlocked Zambia suffered severe imperial exploitation, which is standard on a continent so richly endowed with an abundance of resources that for ages condemned its people to the legacy of dehumanization and deprived them of the fundamental rights to earn the benefits which should accrue to its people, leaving behind a trail of poverty, hunger, and disease. In Jamaica, Dr. Kenneth Kaunda will always be remembered for his attendance at the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting in 1975. It was his masterly and adroit chairing of the Commonwealth Head of Government in Lusaka in 1979, with the astute support of Secretary General Sonny Ramfo and the strong backing of Julius Nyerere and Michael Manley, that broke Margaret Thatcher's obstinacy and secured a critical breakthrough which resulted in the Lancaster House Conference for the Independence of Zimbabwe. He also supported the liberation struggles in Angola, Mozambique, and stood against South Africa's repeated interference and unlawful control of Namibia. As a frontline estate, his mission would not end until true freedom was won for all Southern African countries. Such a courageous stand presented considerable development challenges for Zambia, a landlocked country depending on copper export, which experienced price validity. He was never afraid to pay the price for his abiding principle. History cannot ignore the unrelenting hostility and unwavering support in the struggle against apartheid, which eventually concluded with the election of Nelson Mandela as president of South Africa in 1994. We have lost the last iconic African leader of a generation. Nkrumah, Nyerere, Samora Mako, Kenyatta, Lumumba, Robert Mugabe, Mandela, Sekou Toure, who all fought to remove the colonial rule that from the entire continent of Africa and to restore the pride of its great people. Our sincere condolences to his immediate families and friends as Dr. Kaunda joins the ancestral realm. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank you, Naomi, for your tribute. And now we shall have Ghanaman from the Promote Ghana Foundation. Let's welcome him.
Good morning to you all, my Ghanaian brothers and sisters. I go by the name Ghanaman, the systematic universal patriotism campaigner. For those of you who are seeing me for the first time, I am the one who is walking across the country propagating the message of patriotism. Last 3 years, I walked from Accra to from Accra to Kumasi in 7 days. Last 2 years, I walked from Accra to Ho in 7 days, and next year, we'll be walking from Accra to Takrade, propagating the message of patriotism. Now, tribute on behalf of Bosikaman Protuga Foundation, committed to reviving the spirit of patriotism across the globe, to Dr. Kenneth Kaunda, the first president of the Republic of Zambia. We were all born great, but only few exhibit their greatness to the general well-being of humanity. And there is no doubt that Dr. Kenneth Kaunda was among such. Sir, you live long. Sir, you live well. And say you live strong. You remain the last pillar standing in the Pan-African struggle long after the generals of your generation had departed. You took on the baton, and as a man of great courage, you held on to life. You worked hard to preserve and pass on the memories, the values, the relics, and the baton, as well as we did not meet in our lifetime great Pan-African heroes, the likes of Dr. Nkrumah and Dr. DuBois of blessed memory, to name a few, but you were among the great. We heard the stories not only from your lips when we arrived on the scene, but you hold to it. You told it to us with your life and legacy. Indeed, the continent of Africa has lost a great and lustrous son. Africa appreciates you for believing in her and for doing all things possible to make her shine from the darkest pit she was placed. Africa, your mother mourns your loss. Your brothers and sisters are sad, but you are never stuck in our sorrows. We remain hopeful, for we believe that when a good seed is buried in the earth, there is a high expectation of healthy germination and then lead to a bountiful harvest. Therefore, as you go down the soil today, signifying the planting of our good seed, we look forward to a great yield of all those that you have imparted to carry on with the pursuit of making Africa free and great. Even though we weep, we take consolation in the fact that you have given a lot to be carried on. Therefore, we say, goodbye, fellow compatriot. Goodbye, great son of the African soil. Goodbye. To a man who shall forever be in our hearts and our minds. Thank you.
Thank you, Ghanaman. We'll now hear from a representative of Sima Records to speak with us, Mrs. Mavis Sintim Abuaje.
Good morning, honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, everybody. I'm very honored to be here this morning to give tribute to a great man. For me, a great opportunity in this lifetime to be here. But before I do that, I would love to sing. Oh, pirates, yes, there am I. The soul died to the merchant ship. Minute after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hands of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. So won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? It's all I ever had. Redemption songs. Redemption songs. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery, but none but ourselves can free our mind. Well, I have no fear for atomic energy, but none of them can stop at the time. How long shall they kill our prophet while we stand aside and look? Ooh. Some say it's just a part of it, that we've got to fulfill the book. So won't you help to sing another song of freedom? It's all I ever had. Redemption song. Redemption songs. Redemption songs. Redemption songs. Thank you. Thank you very much, Madam Chairperson, honorable members here present, Nananom, members of the media, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and our protocols observed. It is with a great honor for me to be asked to pay tribute to the life of the selfless Africans who struggled with their lives and fought for the total liberation of the African continent from the oppressions of colonial rule, particularly the apartheid regime of the Southern Africa. Persons who dedicated their lives selflessly fighting to establish the principle of respect for the sanctity and dignity of life are praiseworthy. They are champions of peace and justice, and their lives are worthy of celebration. Life is most precious of all treasures in the universe. A single life is worth more than all the treasures in the universe. And that is why the life of those who give hope to the hopeless are praiseworthy of celebrating. Your Excellency, Kenneth Kaunda, KK for short, you were one of such persons. Like Mahatma Gandhi of India, you bravely employ the most powerful weapons, dialogue and nonviolence, to help liberate your country, Zambia,
the Southern Africa, and indeed the entire African continent from the abuse of human dignity. Yes, you belong to the last of a generation of African leaders who fought for the peace and happiness of the African. Indeed, today, we celebrate not your life alone, but the lives of those brave Africans who fought alongside you for the emancipation of Africa. Nelson Mandela of South Africa, Patrick Lumumba of Democratic Republic of the Congo, Jomo Kenyatta of Kenya, Sekou Touré of Guinea, Nnamdi Azikiwe of Nigeria, and Dr. Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana, to mention just a few. The 21st century indeed is a century of Africa. Due to our pioneering struggle during the last 50 years of the century, I pray for the early repose of your great life while I salute you for a life wealthy of praise and emulation. You are my hero. You are a champion of history. I bow to your great life. Thank you. The name is Afro Songstress Lily M, aka Mami Kales. Thank you very much for having me here.
The drums can continue while I'm organizing myself. I feel like a chief, you know. Good assay. Thank you. Thank you. Good assay. Happy to be Another Kaunda quote that I found, which I'm sure will engage your minds, the inability of those in power to still the voices of their own consciences is the great force leading to change. Kenneth Kaunda. Awesome. Just thinking of my, just growing up and the kind of books that my father made us read, and didn't know why, but back then, but Marcus Garvey, Philosophy and Opinions of Marcus Garvey. Then we had this great Senegalese writer, Cheikh Anta Diop, African Origin of Civilization. And then he was telling me about how he nearly went to Congo to fight in 1966, but the coup saved him. Somebody put his name down when he was in second university and said, hey, you volunteered to go and fight. You know, and my mother was talking about her young pioneer days. So we had this Pan-African thing stewing nicely. And it's, I think that served me well because it's given me an appreciation of where we are right now and where we have to go, and the contributions of people like Nkrumah and Azikiwe and all the greats, including Dr. Kaunda. So it's great to be part of this event, hosting this photo exhibition and eulogy. We thank God for the lives of all these great men and women who made this happen. I just want to acknowledge a couple of you here. You're all welcome. We also have the ambassador, Bennett from the Diaspora Africa Forum, who's here with us. We also have from the National Interest Movement, Dr. Abu Sakara, who's here. We have Ivor Covenor Greenstreet, former flag bearer of the Convention People's Party, who's here with us as well. We also have with us Dr. Kingsley Opoku Emening, and Opari Ado, Greater Accra, Regional Chair of the CPP, Nana Obri, Nana Bimpong II, Adjuso Hini Kufuridwa. And as we go along, I'll be recognizing a couple more people. And right now, we would like to have the tribute of the Convention People's Party. And it's my pleasure to welcome, to speak on behalf of the CPP, deliver their tribute, Mr. Ivor Covenor Greenstreet. Let's welcome him.
Chairperson of the Convention People's Party, Nana Frimpomah, Dr. Abu Sakara, leader of the National Interest Movement, and also former flag bearer of the Convention People's Party, Your Excellencies from the Diplomatic Corps, all protocols observed. It is a great honor and pleasure for me to be asked on behalf of the party to say a few words in tribute to this great man, this great soul, and this great warrior for the cause of African freedom and for the liberation of her people. A struggle that he began with many others across the continent, and a struggle that we all know still continues unabated. Anybody who has had the opportunity to dwell on the lives of these key statesmen and liberators in general, and Dr. Kaunda in particular, may have had occasion to have watched an interview that was conducted by Martin Luther King with Dr. Kaunda many years ago. And in that interview, what you will get a sense of, and certainly what I got a sense of, is that this man, the son of a teacher, was a real gentleman, and he remained a real gentleman throughout his life. But not only that, he was such a deep thinker. And as those of you who may be interested in studying politics and leaders and political science will know that he talked about something called Zambian humanism, in the same way that Dr. Nkrumah spoke about conscientism and Nkrumahism, and in the same way that Nyerere spoke about what he called Ujuma, and how our relations with each other are so important. And when you reflect on how they applied themselves so vigorously, their thoughts so vigorously, to the improvement of the lives of the nations they represented, and the selfless nature they went about carrying out these activities, then these were real men. They were real individuals who came not to serve themselves, but to serve their societies, their communities, and their nations. And one can draw so much inspiration from such conduct from these great statesmen. And it's this type of inspiration that we need to guide and lead us today as we continue with the diverse problems that we all face as nations. And we should therefore not be afraid to apply the same depth of thought, the same depth of commitment that they demonstrated to their nations, to our own problems and our own nations today. Certainly, we are grateful for his service to his nation and to Africa as a whole. We wish his family well, and we wish him well on his journey across the river. We are grateful. Thank you very much.
We pray for the day that this COVID thing disappears so we just stop sanitizing all the time. It's just getting crazy. We have a spoken word, music, poetry, performance from one of our great musicians, poets, performers, broadcasters coming up in a short while. But I want to recognize some members of the diplomatic community who are here with us. Ambassador Pedro Luis de Spain Gonzalez from the Embassy of the Republic of Cuba is here with us. Ambassador, good to see you. High Commissioner Grace Mason from the beautiful country of South Africa, who's here with us. We have the counselor from the Angolan Embassy, Joel Kumbo, who's here with us. And from the Zambia High Commission, we have Deshaun Mambire, who's here with us. Zambia is in the house. Yes. Thank you. And from Ghana, West Africa, we have Black Rasta, who is here with us. Black Rasta, please come up and do your thing. A foremost, ardent, and proudly Pan-African gentleman who breathes fire every afternoon on Xylophone 102.1. Rasta, please, you know my job. MC stands for Master of Cleanliness. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. COVID, go away. Come again another day, right?
Yes.
Never come again. Go ahead, bro.
Okay, this is mine.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm going to do a small poem here for Kenneth Kaunda. And then... when there is time, we'll do a musical performance as well. Thank you so much for coming to honor Kenneth Kaunda. Now, we have a group of people in Africa called the Bisa people. In Ghana, we call them the Busanga people. In their language, the black man is called Guakunda. Guakunda. The title of this poem is A Letter to Kaunda, a great Guakunda. The sun rose steadily again over the northern Rhodesian Chinsal Mountains. It was the third time, unprecedentedly, the sun smiled on your small, sweet sound birth with blessings. The jubilation was an honor to a great black man, the Guakunda. No wonder. With a double ponder, you were named Kaunda. The keys of the Zambian liberation were handed over to you by the powers of the universe. Gradually and tactically, you maneuvered the rocky road of the Zambian independence with such power and prowess. Hey, Kaunda, the great Guakunda. Now, you are reunited with another Guakunda called Nkrumah. Oh, what a wow. When the two lions shake the gates of heaven to deny the African traitors whose only interest was bunga bunga, your fear that African unity may have fizzled with the betrayal of Nkrumah has almost become true, with yet another set of tribalistic traitors revising, dividing, and segregating the holy visions of Nkrumah with no respect to karma. You led an immaculately splendid life whilst you were here with us. You selflessly handed dignity to us without a doubt on a safe running bus. Forgive us our trespasses as we try to repair the disconnected wires in the brains of our citizenry, leading the way to temptation, imperialism, and neo-colonialism. Kaunda, tell Nkrumah that Ghana has fallen into the hands of those who bombed him night and day. Those whose only interest was in destroying the legacy of the Osagyefo that was laid. Those who claim that the CPP is no more and still struggling to get a seat in parliament. Hey, did they say the CPP was only existent on the internet? Wow. Is it really true? There is hope though, as the spirit of the Osagyefo never dies nor surrenders. The times are coming when the cock shall crow again and the mantra of forward ever would come again, dismantling all traitors into ashes and cinders. Kaunda, Africa remembers you till the next world. Kaunda, the great Guakunda, Ghana embraces you with the love of a mother, solid and wild. Thank you. All right, ready with the rhythm? So this one is a combination of Jamaican reggae and, of course, Ghanaian Adoa. If Nkrumah was alive today and walking with us, he would be embracing a rhythm like this. Pan-Africanist rhythm, Jamaica, Ghana combined. Are you ready, Herbalist Band? This band is called the Herbalist Band. We believe in herbs that heal the nation. Are you ready? Ready. Yes. Boko. Let's go.
Send a letter from home. Send a letter from home.
Since you left home, my darling, no. Since you left home, my darling, no. You never cared to let me know. You never cared to let me know. A long time I left Africa for Babylon. I thought Africa was a bad theater. America was heaven and theater. I saw Megasa
in America.
I saw madmen
in America.
Homosexuals
in America.
I saw lesbians
in America.
But now I know Paris is too late. Come on, darling, and be my dear. Come on, darling, and be my dear. Come on.
Send my letter from home.
Send my letter from home. Since you left home, my darling.
Since
Please don't be lazy. You saw the pretty ladies here. Why did you cut the song sharp? Play that, please. Ready? All right, we go. No go. Hey, Nkrumah will be so proud of this. I'm going to do is from my hometown. I was born and bred in the north, and normally this song, we don't do it at midnight. The last time I witnessed them mistakenly do it at midnight, somebody became a goat. Yeah. It's a taboo song. We only do it in the daytime. 12 midnight. If you want to be a goat, sing this song. Anywhere I perform it around the world, I check the time. And if I want the people to become goats, I let them sing it. Thankfully, it's not midnight yet. Are you ready? This one is called Zantambua, the Goat Dance. Rhythm! Spent. I'm going to do the very last one so we can zoom into the rest of the meeting. Now, this song gave me a lot of glory around the world. Robert Mugabe, a very powerful Pan-Africanist, invited me to Zimbabwe. And when I arrived, he came over to my hotel with all honor and respect. At that time, he was 92 years old. And he said, "Black Rasta, you know I love Frimpomah." I said, "Oh yes, that's an understatement. There's one song you cannot do in this country." And I was wondering, I don't sing profane songs. What is this handsome old man saying? He said, "You cannot sing Barack Obama in Zimbabwe." I was shocked because when I do this song, I electrify every crowd. Here was the man who invited us for his 92nd birthday, saying, "You can't do the song here." He realized the disappointment on my face. He said, "So change the name Barack Obama and put Robert Mugabe there." Then he turned around sharply. "Better still, take it out and put Kwame Nkrumah there." I believe you wouldn't have a problem if I perform Barack Obama. Would you? Would you? No problem. Thank you so much. He was a great guy. All right. So no problem with the meeting. All right. So read him, Barack Obama. "Your Rasta, when he asked some black man saying what turn American president, him thinks that I'm going to sit out there and watch him."
Mama. Come back with Barack Obama.
Papa, sing.
back with Tago. Come back with talk about Barack Obama. Barack, Barack, Barack Obama. Barack, Barack, Barack. One more time. Mama, mama. Come back with Tago. Come back with talk about Barack Obama. Papa, papa. Sing. Come back with Tago. Come back with talk about Barack Obama. Barack, Barack,
Barack Obama.
Hey, Barack, Barack. Originally stepping from Outer Kenya, Africa, adopted into the cold woodlands of America. Just me, I am. Them youth defy every order and turn senator. The gunshot of hate continue for echo in America. How come black man become president in a money maker? Barack be we, Barack be we, Barack be we. Before them turn your name into Barack Osama. In this time, judgment has come without water for legalizing unnecessary abortion in America. A fire! Fire!
Mama, mama, come back with Tago. Come back with Tago, Barack Obama.
Hey, papa, papa, come back with Tago. Come back with Tago, Barack Obama.
Barack, Barack, Barack Obama.
Hey, Barack, Barack,
Barack Obama. Mama, mama.
Sing! Come back with Tago.
Come back with Tago, Barack Obama.
Hey, papa, papa. Come back with Tago. Come back with Tago, Barack Obama.
Barack, Barack, Barack Obama. Barack, Barack, Barack Obama.
9/11 was the beginning of Satan end time. Baptizing black Americans in a bitter juice line. Making sure no black man in America will see his prime. Pan black people, flesh and blood, the Ku Klux Klan love for dying. Wake up Obama and intensify your power timeline. Or else, Brethren Obama, your dark days will never ever sublime.
Mama, mama. Come and put a cabo, Barack Obama.
Papa, papa.
Come and put a cabo. Come and put a cabo, Barack Obama.
Barack, Barack,
Barack Obama.
Barack, Barack.
Brush your sheep, grazing in the territory. Father Barack, watch out. Some don't love you.
You don't know how to take it.
Father Barack, watch out. Too many righteous be sacrificed for this very same system.
Uh-huh.
As you keep the fire burning, black president.
Here I got you. Up in the north, they say.
Barack Obama.
In the south, them say.
Barack Obama.
In the west, them say.
Barack Obama.
In the east, them say.
Barack Obama.
In the top, them say.
Barack Obama.
In the bottom.
Barack Obama.
And everybody say.
Barack Obama.
Nkrumah even say.
Barack Obama.
Why is the rhythm so slow?
Barack Obama.
Is this the new drunken band?
Barack Obama.
Rhythm come for. Thank you. Appreciate it. Forward ever. Backward never, Black Rasta. For real. For real. Thank you. Okay. So we are. COVID things. Anyway, we're just about wrapping up this side of the program, which is the eulogy, and then we'll go in for the photo exhibition. Brief statements coming from, first of all, the PNC who are here with us. The PNC have a brief statement followed by the National Interest Movement. So PNC, let's put our hands together for PNC as they deliver their brief statements as we eulogize the life and times of
Dr. Kenneth, Kaunda. If the PNC are not here, we shall go straight to the National Interest Movement, and I'm pleased to call on Dr. Abu Sakara to deliver his statement. Thank you. You know I have to do it, right?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Chairman of the Convention People's Party, my good brother, Ivor Greenstreet, distinguished members of the diplomatic corps, our friends from East Africa, Karibu Sana, Los Hermanos de Cuba, bienvenidos. Today is, I would not say a sad day, because it marks the end of an era in which they have done their part. The question is, what is our part? And are we prepared to do it? That is the only way we carry on the legacy of the founding fathers. I was privileged to live in Uganda for 4 years. It was my first posting. And during that time, I had several meetings with our distinguished leader, Kenneth Kaunda. One thing that struck you living in Zambia, wherever you went, from the smallest hamlet to the biggest gathering, was a pervasive sense of national unity, a pervasive sense of oneness. And this was his gift to the people of Uganda. It is no wonder that he focused on building human relationships. I don't know whether Black Rasta has gone or he's still around. Black Rasta, are you still around? I would very much like him to stay till the end. Black Rasta. I want us at the end to pay tribute to my father here, because I thought that today of all days, you will do Tiende Pamozi Nti Maumo, Tiende Pamozi Nti Maumo, Tiende Pamozi Nti Maumo, Tiende Pamozi Nti Maumo, Unipitie, Tiende Pamozi Nti Maumo. I'm going to do that with you at the end, and we wave him goodbye. This basically says, let us march together as one. Let us march together in one heart. It has several verses, but the key thing was a sense of national unity. Throughout his period in Zambia, Dr. Kaunda never, ever forgot the contribution of Kwame Nkrumah and Ghanaians to Uganda. I remember in his very last year, I was there when President Carter came to visit him. And one of the issues for discussion was in ushering in the period of multi-party democracy after a long period. During that period, he invited the whole delegation, I being the counter representative, accompanied President Carter there. And he had hurt his hand playing golf. He liked playing golf. So he proceeded to serve each member of the delegation himself, pouring the cups of tea for everyone. When it came to my time, he said to me, "Oh, young man, did you see anything strange when you were entering this presidential lodge?" I said, "Not particularly, sir. I only saw a beaten up old Land Rover on blocks right at the entrance. And I always wondered, why would this car be doing here? You'd think that they would have parked a nice limousine there. He said, aha, you noticed. He said, that car is from Ghana. It was the first support we had in our liberation struggle, which Kwame Nkrumah sent to us. And up till today, I don't know whether it's still there today, it had the number plates from Ghana on that Land Rover, and he put it there for all to see and recognize the role that Ghana played in the liberation of Zambia. Today, as we celebrate his life and his passing, the question on my mind is, what are we, the successor generation, going to do with this independence which has been bequeathed to us? Often we think the independence is the flag and the nation. It cannot be. A nation can be conquered, the flag can be torn, but the independent spirit in the people can never be vanquished. And it is this independence of ourselves, our thoughts, that we must rethink anew as we recast for ourselves a new future where we find ourselves in the country today. Because there are many questions to be asked of the successor generation. We are the privileged ones. We are the ones who are the benefit of independence. Some of us were born in the year of independence, so we never knew colonial rule. We had the best of everything. Our parents, some of them were educated, but they never had the opportunity to know what the world was really like, because they never lived outside Ghana and they never lived amongst other peoples. But we did. Name any continent, any country, that you will not have had a Ghanaian there of our generation. Yet we have all these advantages, and as a successor generation, we are failing in the second leg of the independence, which is emancipation of our people. We must learn to think outside the box. Learn to think outside of the parameters set for us. Learn to think outside party politics and begin to ask ourselves that very individual question: how can I think anew and create a new path to lead to that destination where the vision of our founding fathers pointed to? And what was that vision? The vision of a nation that was to be a shining example of what Africans can do for themselves, by themselves, because they believe in themselves. This is our marching order for the day, and I thank you very much. So as we leave, Kaunda never ever attended any meeting without singing his favorite song, Tiende Pamodzi. And the words are very simple. Tiende, let us go. Pamodzi, together, in Ti Maomo, with joint mind. So I want us all to stand up and give him a last rendition of his Tiende Pamodzi song, and I'll wave him goodbye with his white handkerchief, which he never left anywhere. Black Rasta, are you around? Your voice is better than mine, so the words are very simple. It's Tiende Pamodzi Nti Maomo. 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 Unipitie Tiende Pamodzi Nti Maomo. Tiende Limpopo Nti Maomo. Tiende Limpopo Nti Maomo. Tiende Limpopo Nti Maomo. Tiende Limpopo Nti Maomo. Unipitie Tiende Limpopo Nti Maomo. Tiende Ayuti Nti Maomo. Tiende Ayuti Nti Maomo. Tiende Ayuti Nti Maomo. Tiende Amosi Nti Maomo. Unipitie. Kaunda itie tiende pamoti ntima uko
So you're wondering what the words meant. I know at least one person who can let us know what the words of that song meant. He will wrap everything else for us in a short while. Last but one statement is from the General Secretary of the People's National Convention. Let's welcome Janet Nabila for a brief statement from the People's National Convention, after which Mr. Dishon Mambire from the Zambian High Commission will wrap up the eulogies for us, and then we'll proceed to the photo exhibition. Janet Nabila, please. PNC.
Good morning, Chairman and Leader, and all diplomatic corps. We from the PNC have come with a tribute. We have received the news of the demise of the founding father of Zambia, His Excellency Dr. Kaunda, Kenneth David Kaunda, with a deep sense of sadness and immense loss. Dr. Kaunda was one of the great sons of the continent, whose contribution to the liberation of Africa and enhancement of regional integration is immeasurable. He was not only a leading freedom fighter for the independence of African states, but he played a role in the establishment of regional economic communities, including COMSA. A longtime champion of regional integration, Dr. Kaunda remained a constant inspiration through the vision of our founding fathers, which continues to shape and guide our actions. Our region will forever remember Dr. Kaunda for his visionary leadership that firmly believed that economic independence of African states can only be achieved and sustained through unity, peace, and self-reliance. His vision is now our vision of a fully integrated economic community that is prosperous internationally, competitive, and ready to merge into the African economic community. We cannot honor this great Pan-African more than by remaining true to his vision. We pray for his soul to rest in eternal peace. A tribute from PNC. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Ambassador Cabral Blay Amehe, who's here with us. Professor Akilakpa Soya also is here with us. Thank you very much. Remy Edmondson. Yes, indeed, Professor Akilakpa Soya, welcome. Remy Edmondson from the PPP. Muniru Mohammed from the PNC. And just quick run through of some CPP members that we have here. Aisha Suli Futa, National Women's Organizer. Nanaya Jantua, General Secretary. Opari Ado Jr., National Treasurer. Opari Ado Sr., Greater Accra Regional Chair. Kuo Mensah, Greater Accra Secretary. Justice Hinaku, Senior Comrade Waku Abe Abe, Senior Comrade Anaman, Senior Comrade Mr. Soa, Administrator. Marwin Love Kadi, Senior Comrade, as well as Mr. Tosu, Greater Accra Regional Treasurer. And a lady who was the first, I think, female tractor operator for Kwame Nkrumah, who is also here with us. She's here, so we'll give you a wave. Final comments and since we're talking about a great Zambian, it's only right that we have a Zambian to end our eulogies. I'd like to bring on Dishon Mambire from the Zambian High Commission to give us the last statements before we go into the photo exhibitions. The Dishon Mambire, Zambian High Commission. Yes, and he understands the lyrics of the words that Dr. Sakara sang, so I'm sure he will tell us what it means. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm going to rely on the protocols of the previous speakers. The correct pronunciation of my surname is Mambwe, Dishon Mambwe. To start with, we are grateful as Zambia High Commission for the love that you've shown to our founding father, Dr. David Bujisa Kaunda. And I don't have much to say, but what I can say is, for us to honor the legacy that Dr. Kaunda has left is to do exactly what they did with his colleagues, Kwame Nkrumah and the rest. And what is it that they did is to liberate us, to work in unity. They had a vision. We are here today because of the vision they had. And we're a product of free education, university education, because of the vision Dr. Kaunda had. If we sell out Africa, their souls will not rest in peace. Their souls will only rest in peace if we promote unity, if we carry on the vision they had for Africa, an independent Africa. Africa which develops using its own resources. Africa that should not depend on donor funding. Africa which knows what it should do for itself. That is only possible if we carry on the vision they had. They did their part, and it remains upon ourselves. What is it that we can do for Africa, and not what Africa can do for us? Now let me just, in summary, talk about the meaning of the song. Tiende pamozi ndimtima omozi. Let's walk together in unity and with one heart. The meaning of that song comes from Zambia has 73 tribes. And in order for independence to be achieved, there was need for Zambians to unite, a unit of purpose. Not to look at the tribe, the place, the region, the creed, the color, where each one of us came from. But in unity and in one accord, it was made possible for Dr. Kaunda to unite Zambia. And this is what we should do as Africans. We do not have to look at the region. Oh, it comes from Volta region. It comes from the great Accra region. We are one people. All of us fighting to better the lives of our sisters, fighting to better the lives of our daughters, fighting to better the lives of everyone called an African. And that is only possible if we work together, like Kaunda said, tiende pamozi, with one heart, in one accord. That is when we're going to achieve that. Lastly, I'd like to thank you very much. This means a lot for us as Zambia. I'm sure I am not aware if there is anywhere where this is being done in recognition of the way Kaunda did not only for Zambia, but for Africa. So thank you very much. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. Very much. Thank you. I call on our host right now, Nana Frimpomah Sapong Kumankuma, Chair and Leader of the Conventional People's Party, to wrap up this event for us, the first part.
Thank you. Before I say anything, let's have a minute of silence to wrap up this occasion. This is one of those days that you don't know what to say. First of all, I can't even imagine the presence of everyone here on such a very short notice. You all made time to come. I really, really say a big thank you. I know your presence here is for the very same reasons for which we did this thing, and that is to all that we believe in the fight. We believe that what has been done was for the benefit of not just themselves, but for the whole African continent and the whole universe for that matter. Because when all of us are free, when all of us can work together, that is when we can live in a nation, in a country, in a world that we can all prosper as individuals and be able to live to the fullest potential of everything that we have. And when we live to our full potential, then we can share together and be able to build this nation and live it better for the next generation and next generation, and we have a better world. So I know that you are here for that reason. And for that reason, I can say thank you to everybody. All of you here, may God richly bless you, especially those of you that we needed to give you much more time. I know you are busy with your time, but you came. Doctor and everyone that has come here, Dr. Akila Pasoya, all of you, I know that this is a short notice. Some of you were called just like a night ago. I'm so glad you came. Thank you very much. And I believe that as we all move on from here, and as you have come, I just want us to take just one few seconds. I want to make a pledge with myself, and I want to believe that all of us here, as has been said today, we've come here with a purpose. These, like, they have done, they are gone. They've lived their lives. Their contributions that they have done is what most of us here today benefit from. Like it was said, they fought for their independence so that we can be free to govern ourselves, so that we can be free to live to our fullest. The battle is not completed. That we all know. So let's make a pledge within our spirits today that as we live here and going back in our own way, in every single way that we can, let us all pledge to contribute and make this world a better place and make Africa a better place. Let's unite in the way that we can. And beyond that, let's make sure that we are here for a purpose. And the purpose is to ensure that we improve our lives and the lives of the people that we have determined and decided to govern. Let's make sure that the young people on the streets, the old people, and all of us can live a life of meaning. Can live a life of meaning. And I believe that that is exactly what they all fought for. They believe this, and that is why they sacrificed their lives. Our father died in exile. He died in exile for the same fight. And he said that his independence that he was fighting for was meaningless unless it was tied and linked up to the total liberation of the African continent. That is what binds us together, and that is why we are here. And I want to believe that together, all of us here, no matter our differences, we have much more in common than what divides us. Let's all work for this. I make my pledge. I pledge that I'll do whatever I have to do as a Ghanaian, as a leader with my organization, with CPP, as a Ghanaian here with the diasporans, with the Pan-Africanism, with everyone out there, that we will do our best. And I believe you'll do the same. So help me, God. Thank you very much. Thank you. So the next stage, we are all going to go to the to look at a few pictures together. Okay, please, as you see me, my mother on the stage, this is one of the, I'll let you introduce yourself, but it's one of the old icons, the people, he was one time with the Dr. Lehman's resident, Dr. Lehman's government. She was, what did she go there? Please, she's not that old. She's going to talk for herself. She has a song to make, and I really want her to sing it.
DuBois, DuBois, boy, boy. Kaunda, Kaunda, DuBois, Kaunda, Kaunda, DuBois. We bid you goodbye, come and come back, DuBois. We bid you goodbye, Kaunda, boy. I want Kaunda, boy. We've heard a lot about this man. Yes, Nkwamie. Kwame Showboy, we want to see you, Kwame Nkrumah Showboy. We want to see you, Kwame Showboy. Kwame Nkrumah's body lies among in the grave. Who knows that song? Kwame, I am almost 19, so my voice is. Kwame Nkrumah's body lies among. In the, Kwame Nkrumah's body lies a morning in the grave, but his soul goes marching on. Hey, Nkrumah is now a mother. I'm sorry. What Nkrumah is? Hey, you are asleep. Kwame Nkrumah lies, his body lies a morning in the grave, but his soul marches on.
You have a good song, let's sing.
Coming through my body lies a money in the grave. Coming through my body lies a money in the grave. But it's all gone, man.
Thank you, ladies. Beautiful. Please help her down. Be careful. Be careful. It's quite high up here. Thank you. And that brings us to the end of the eulogy part of the show. So our host, Nana Sapong, Frimpomah Sapong, Kumankuma, will cut the tape with representatives from the Zambia High Commission just next door. We'll do a photo exhibition, and we are done for the day. So it's quite instructive that we are here at the W.E.B. DuBois Center, so another great Pan-Africanist, celebrating the life and times of a great Pan-Africanist. And of course, Kwame Nkrumah is just full of symbolism. I want to say thank you very much for your time here. And so our host will be joined by her dignitaries. We'll cut the tape at the exhibition. We'll look at the photos and we'll call it a day, remembering the life of Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. Thank you very much. My name is Kafui Day. It's been a real pleasure. And enjoy the photo exhibition. Let people know that this is what happened here at the W.E.B. DuBois Center. Have a good afternoon. God bless you all.
Will be my day. da Reno Wewum. Waya 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 waya.
batayele, ki batayele, dinutiye karungeye. Am batayele, kubepe kangweya, ki batayele, dinutiye karungeye. Young, we sit in the soya again.